Last week, the country's largest retailer, Walmart, held its annual shareholders meeting in Bentonville, Arkansas.
So let's talk story.
At the same time, injured Walmart workers, union leaders, and political officials held their own meeting in Oakland, California, to help send a message to the shareholders about the unfair treatment they are receiving from their employer. 63-year-old Filipina Maria Umali, who broke her hip while on the job last year, says she just received a termination letter from Walmart due to her long leave of absence. Walmart provided Umali with a caregiver, but she says it is still not enough.
My health cannot get back normal, but at least I need some help. Especially my rent is going up soon again, and they just gave me not too much. And my medication, they keep on declining. Before I got this, I'm already 1 month behind not taking any medicine.
Political officials like Oakland Mayor Libby Schaff and Assemblymember Rob Bonta, the first Fil-Am elected to the state legislature, showed their support for Umali and workers like her.
The practices that Walmart uses in failing to treat their workers with dignity and respect affects all of us. We have some examples of Filipino-American workers here today, but it affects workers of all backgrounds and ethnicities and from all communities. So this is a universal problem.
The workers and their union leaders say they are confident that their message was heard by the top officials at Walmart.
It's not the last. We still keep fighting on.
Along with protecting workers who were hurt on the job, protesters say they are also fighting for better wages. After years of protests by workers, Walmart stores raised its minimum wage to $9 in 2015 and to $10 in 2016. Workers say they will continue to fight for what they call a living wage of $15 an hour. Romel Quinclara, ABS-CBN News, Oakland, California.